Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Well, as you can see, my background is a little different, and have no fear, Eyes on the Sky is not ending or anything. But as many of you know, we had an election in the United States here last Tuesday, and I never ever get political on any of my videos, and I don't really intend to start that now either, but I do kind of want to make a larger point about that. And so therefore, I'm not including my usual black curtain background that I would normally sweep across what you see behind me, because this is kind of a raw, unfiltered thing that I wanted to talk about. And it does have to do with the night sky. But I thought I would give you at least a little more of a glimpse into me, including what you normally see behind me in this basement room of my house, rather than the nice, pretty background that you normally see that focuses on the sky itself. I really wanted to kind of talk about how we as humans relate to the night sky, and I will talk about a spot in the night sky that really has something to do with that too. I do have Stellarium up, just so that you know, but I did want to really kind of concentrate on people for the moment, because I think even people that voted for the winner of the presidential election, a lot of them were even surprised at the result. And as a result of that, I think there are people who are legitimately have concerns, fears, whatever else. And those are valid. And even people that are happy about the election, you know, those are legitimate feelings that they have too. And I don't want to minimize anyone's feelings about the election, and I don't want to talk about that too much. But I do want to talk about how rhetoric in campaigns can be divisive and make us feel like we are separate from each other. And we create these artificial divides between ourselves. And I know that that's easy for me as a white male of relatively decent privilege. I grew up in a middle-class home you know, have a college education. So I know I have a lot of opportunities that other people don't have. And I recognize that and acknowledge those things, and don't want to try to make it sound like I don't understand that I come from a place of privilege, because I do. But I also know that talking about the night sky, sharing what's up above our heads, has connected me to so many people, not just across the country, but across the world, because I have conversed with people from Eastern Europe, from the Middle East, Asia, obviously the United States, Australia, South America, Central America, especially people in the British Islands, United Kingdom, that area, Western Europe. So I know that I have a unique audience that connects with the night sky, that is something that is universal to all of us. And I use that term universal with great intention here too. What I do want to talk about is that despite any divisions we feel exist between us at a micro level, particularly when elections occur, on a macro level, we are all very much the same, despite whatever artificial divisions we try to create for ourselves. And let me talk about another fellow amateur astronomer by the name of Joe Guzman, who helped me to see this with better clarity several years back when I first met him. He would do outreach opportunities at the Adler Planetarium, as well as other places around the city of Chicago, through all its light pollution and everything else. But the beautiful thing about being out at the Adler, particularly when the weather was warm, is you would get people from all walks of life, people visiting the city of Chicago, whatever else, from all kinds of nationalities. And the one thing that always connected everyone, no matter what, was the fact that we had telescopes there and people were interested in that. And there was this bond that is created between people of vastly different religions, ethnic backgrounds, financial backgrounds, genders, sexual orientation, anything, that all that gets wiped away when you're talking about the night sky. And here's why I think that is. We are all interested in where we came from, and we all have differing ideas about that. But the thing about the night sky is that we are all looking at our future selves when we look at the stars. And that's because a star in the past, or multiple stars in the past, that exploded in supernova and created the elements that we find on Earth today and in our own bodies, carbon, oxygen, calcium, iron, all those trace elements, they were formed in a gas cloud, in an open cluster that created our sun, which created our solar system, which created Earth. And of course, on Earth, that's where we were all created. And we are all that stardust. Every single one of us came from one or several supernova explosions. All of the elements that we have come from that. And so when we look up into the night sky and we see another star, we see our future selves. We see what Carl Sagan called a way for the universe to know itself. And I think that was a very profound statement, because we as intelligent creatures that have the capacity to look up at the night sky and understand it and see it and say, that is amazing, that is universal, that is vast, it is immense. And we then feel incredibly small. We realize how small we are when we think of that vastness and immenseness, and our parochial small concerns of things like elections and things like that become secondary or tertiary, and we realize that we are all in this together, no matter our skin color, no matter our gender, no matter our orientation on anything. So what I want to encourage you to do is to go out and share the night sky with others and talk about that. And what I want to do is point out something that you can easily point out to anyone, because you can probably see it with your naked eye, and other people can see it with their naked eye too, and that is the Pleiades star cluster, because the Pleiades is a relatively young cluster. It's rising in the east right now. It is going to be if you turn to the right from Capella, zero magnitude star, can't miss that, and it's right above Aldebaran in Taurus the Bull. The Pleiades is a cluster that can either be viewed with binoculars, or if you have a short focal length telescope with a long focal length lens, you may be able to get the entirety of it in there and share it that way too. But the Pleiades, being a young cluster, they're hot white stars that are likely to die in a supernova and create those elements that we came from. And so who knows, someday those elements from those eventual exploded stars may become intelligent beings that look back and see the remnants of our solar system in some 4, 5, 6 billion years as well. So talking about those things and talking about those types of objects that we see up there is something that we all can relate to. It's something that we all find amazing and larger than ourselves, and helps us to remember that we are all on this planet Earth together. We are all on this same spaceship revolving around our sun. And we need to protect it, and we need to be mindful of each other and remember each other. So I would encourage you to go out and share the Pleiades with other people in the future, because you can talk about that star cluster that is 450 light years away from us and only 75 to 150 million years old. And just give a little bit of information about it. Talk about how far away it is. Talk about how long that light traveled, that it traveled 450 years to get to their eye, and those photons ended their journey on that person's eye. They went all that distance across all that space just to reach their eye. And that's one of those kind of mind-blowing types of things that people go, wow, that's pretty cool. And not everyone will do that, but a lot of people will. But I've really never seen anything quite like sharing the night sky through a telescope or with binoculars with people as a way to bring so many people together, just with a little bit of understanding and joy that they find in doing those things. So again, I don't want to really touch on the political aspect too much, other than to just say, let's remember that the night sky connects us all. We can see it from the world over, And we can share it from the world over as well, no matter where we are. The Pleiades is one of those objects that should be visible from just about anywhere, except for some very extreme southern locations. But for most of the world, we can see that, we can find it, and we can share it. And particularly when the moon is full, a lot of times because we run away from light pollution because we're trying to find a darker site to go visit things, and we very often either just come together as amateur astronomers or go away by ourselves to view the night sky. So in this circumstance, I'm actually asking you to go in towards light pollution. You could talk about light pollution with people. You could talk about what we see overhead. And we can also connect as human beings, because we're all human beings and we all came from that stardust together. And that's what connects us. So connect with people that way when the moon is full or nearly full, when you wouldn't be out at a dark site anyway, and discover what joy there can be in sharing the night sky with other people. And I almost never ask for this, but if you do find my videos, and particularly this video, to be something that connects with you, then please consider donating. I rarely ask for this. I just usually have a graphic at the end that mentions it, but your donation really does help. It helps me to be able to take the time to make these videos and to know that other people are connecting with them and sharing them and getting the kind of usefulness from them that helps them to find things and hopefully to help them encourage others to also find things as well. So please consider donating and also sharing this video if you think it might be something that other people might connect with as well. So go out and look at the Pleiades this week, and remember, we're all human. So keep your eyes on the sky, your outdoor lights aimed down, so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.